singers were involved in the music of Band Slam.
Everything they wrote for us rocks, and it fits perfectly with the classic tracks in the movie, from Cheap Trick to David Bowie.
And think about it, they pretty much had to create a sound for bands that didn't even exist outside of the director's head.
We have a lot of eclectic music in the film, and really trying to hone in on that so that we're trying to educate on what is the great music out there, but also present it in a way to them that is contemporary for today.
I think it's been amazing just being able to, you know, go through so many different songs that are, you know, hits, that are classic.
Rock history is more than Elvis and the Beatles, and the idea that people will actually go and be exposed, this can be like a history lesson.
Lucky to have the music team working with us. We had so many wonderful people sort of weighing in and helping us find these songs, choose these songs, write these songs.
As it turned out, the song Amphetamine, which is a big song for I Can't Go On and Won't Go On, was written by my friend Steve Whipp.
Amphetamine is an amazing song. It's like one of my favorite songs, and I was like, yes, I'm gonna sing this song, it's so cool. And I was like, when are we gonna film this?
Band Slam, we need to find that one great song that says who we really are.
I get to do a cover song of Everything I Own, so we made it our own and made it kind of ska-esque.
And then you've got kind of the classic rock with Cheap Trick. Someone to Fall Back On is a beautiful song and really well written. To be able to have a variety of music, you know, that people can definitely respect.
That our soundtrack is something that if no movie existed, you could still release this soundtrack as a record made by a band, and that I would then listen to it and say, that's good, I'm gonna buy that record. That was the goal, and I feel really confident that we did it.
Putting a band together is hard, but ska bands are another story altogether. Ska is a type of music that originated in Jamaica. It has a kind of reggae sound, but it's a little more rocking on the offbeat.
It looks like someone's done their ska homework.
Hey, they typically have a lot of members because there are a lot of instruments going on.
I cast or actors who actually play instruments, and if they didn't, they learned to play what they had to play for this movie. You know, they're also really good actors, and they had to be right for the parts, and they are, and they have great chemistry, but musically, they had to really be phenomenal, and they are.
Okay, you know what a reggae groove is, cross stick. There we go, kick drum.
As a musician, as soon as I see a scene, and I see that the drummer's not really hitting what I'm hearing, or I see that somebody's looking down at their hand a little too much when they're playing guitar, it immediately takes me out of it.
No wonder you are a legend.
I've been acting since I was 5, and I've been playing music since I was 8, and I've always wanted to do a movie that incorporated music. And, you know, I was just like, this is it. This is what I've been waiting for. I was like, this is me.
No offense, but it seems like you're trying way too hard to be Flea from the Red Hot Chili Peppers.
Come on, man. I don't want to be Flea. I don't even like Flea.
Yeah, what's your name? Bug?
Before the movie, we had 2 weeks of rehearsals where we would be learning the music, I would be learning how to play the guitar, and everyone would be rehearsing the songs.
Camp just consisted of just working. We worked with them 12 hours a day for, you know, 2.5-3 weeks, just rehearsing, rearranging, rehashing. You shelter me from home. Can't be
warm. You can't be warm. Before the movie, I had just played, you know, this side of the guitar. Then when I started playing this movie, I was like, gotta start playing on this side of the guitar. So it was a struggle, and I've been having to work, and I've got the blisters to prove it.
I had never picked up a guitar until a month and a half ago, and now I'm playing all three of my songs.
Pretend anymore. able to take this band of people that had never been in a band together and really make them sound like a band. You know, they wanted to do it, and they started to gel, and it sort of became a magical experience.
It's like everybody was like into it, and we're like rocking out. It wasn't even like we were acting, it was just like we were there enjoying it.
After that, we went into pre-records where we were in the studio recording. We all were in a giant room together.
Most of Matt even been in the recording studio other than Allie and Vanessa, who are recording artists.
And we just recorded the entire song, and I went in later for my own vocals. And it was a lot of fun. That's where we all bonded and got to know each other.
It's not normal, you know, for everybody to just be able to hang like that and, you know, goof around and make music together.
You know, they're really playing. You look on screen and you don't have to worry. They actually are the ones playing the tracks, and I think that's huge.
Great.
Stay tuned. We'll be right back with more Band Slam.